and the meek shall inherit the land forever. The songwriter said, there's a land that is fairer than day, but by faith you shall see it afar. All these things that he telling us about is forever. The only meek inherit is forever. There's the land, meek shall inherit the land. Is forever also. And so let us continue to praise the Lord for his promises true. Back to our assistant, praise the pastor, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Bless the Lord one more time.
Praise the Lord.
Bless the Lord one more time.
Praise the Lord.
Can we just stand on our feet and just begin to worship the Lord? Can we just say thank you, Jesus? You are awesome. You are great. You are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords. You are the born and brilliant. You are the conquering child of Judah. Amen. Let's look back where the Lord has brought us from. Hallelujah, hallelujah. May that not be from the Lord. From our son, thank you. Praise the Lord Jesus. The book of Acts, chapter 16, we read from 16 to 26. Let us start in reverence to the reading of God's holy word. And it reads us, and it came to pass, as we went to buy, a certain damsel possessed with a spirit of divination met us, which brought our masters much gain by soothsaying. The same power Paul and us in Christ, saying, these are the servants of the Most High God, which show us the way of salvation. And this is she did many days, but Paul, being grieved, turned and said to the Spirit, I command thee in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her. And came out the same hollow. And when our master saw that the hope of their gain was gone, they caught Paul and Silas and drew them, hallelujah, into the marketplace unto the rulers, and brought them to the magistrates, saying, these are the men, the Jews, do exceedingly trouble our city. Hallelujah. That's verse 16 now. We are now at verse 21. Praise the Lord. For those that missed it, of chapter 16 of Acts. Praise the Lord. And teach custom which are not lawful to us to receive, neither to obey. Be holy. And the multitude rose up against them, and the magistrate ripped off their clothes, and commanded to beat them. And when they had laid this tribe upon them, they cast them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely. Who having received such charge, these are now the jailer, they throw them into the inner prison, that is the depth of the prison, praise the Lord, and made their feet fastened to the stock, to the ground. Somebody praise him. And at midnight, Paul and Silas pray and sing praises unto God. And the prisoner heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation of the prison was shaken. And immediately, all the doors were open, and every man bound was loose. Somebody say loose. Somebody shake your foot and say loose. Somebody shake your hand and say loose. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The seven levels of praise. Hallelujah. You may be seated, praise the Lord Jesus. Paul and Silas, they went to have a prayer. Praise the Lord Jesus. And in the middle of them going to pray and to see the face of God, we see that they encounter a spirit. A spirit, amen, that said, these are the man of God. Praise the Lord Jesus. Was the spirit telling them lies? Was the spirit telling them lies? These are the man of God. The spirit was saying the truth. Ah, my God, but it was indeed a spirit of divination. A spirit that looked and sound like it's the Holy Ghost, but it's not. A spirit, amen, that mimics the children of God. Praise the Lord Jesus. That is why we have to have the Spirit of God to search the things that operate around us. Praise the Lord Jesus. why the spirit will see in the people of God, because he's not there. The spirit is of God. We praise the Lord Jesus. Ah, the spirit was talking the truth, but it was not the spirit of God. And Paul, when being grieved, spoke to the spirit. Hallelujah. And by Paul speaking to the spirit and joining out the spirit, Paul then put himself in trouble, Paul and Silas, because the gain has not moved out of their hands. And when gains are removed, there comes a struggle. Somebody praise the Lord. Then Paul and Silas now were put in prison. Somebody praise the Lord Jesus. Let's stay here a while. We're coming back to it, because we are talking about the seven level of praise. And praise, you see, there are seven words in the Hebrew for praise and worship. Seven words. We praise the Lord Jesus. Seven. You see, oftentimes in what we look at it, we see the one word praise, but it is seven different words. We praise the Lord. And so we want to look at each of them tonight. Praise the Lord Jesus. And the first one we look at is Ha, Heha, Heha. That is H-A-L-A-L. Heha, Heha. And Heha means to jump, to dance, to be loud and chorus. Praise the Lord Jesus. Our God, this happened. You do an Heha when you start to jump, you start to shout, and you start praising God like a crazy. We praise the Lord Jesus. Our God, let's look at the somebody who will turn to Psalms 150. That's the book of Psalms 150, verse 2. Praise the Lord Jesus. Can I have a reading with you?
Praise him for his mighty power.
Praise him for what?
For his mighty power.
For his mighty
power. Praise him according to his excellent grace.
Praise him according to his excellent greatness. And so this worship, you are praising God for his goodness. You are praising God because when we think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he has done, all we can do is to give him a hand. Somebody praise the Lord Jesus. And so that is one of the level of praise. We praise God for his goodness. We praise him for his mercy. We praise him for his favor. So I praise the Lord Jesus. Can somebody just give him a hand? Just one of our hands. Hallelujah. It means to come. Can anybody jump right now? It means to dance. Hallelujah. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. The Bible said a little kid, a little child will lead them, a little child will teach them, and that little baby right there, my little son, might he taught me something, amen, the other day when I was looking at this particular one. This one is Yada. Somebody say Yada. Somebody say Yada. And Yada means to throw your hands up. Forward, while naked, somebody praise the Lord. While naked, I'm not confession to God. Yada, me Lord, I surrender. I surrender to thee. That's why when you see somebody coming into the house of God, and you see them just waving their hand, you just say, the Lord. He stretched out his hand. Somebody praise the Lord. And because he stretched out his hand, he stretched it out like, "Daddy, you lift me up right now." And then that's when I realized that Yahweh don't just mean my surrender. Praise the Lord Jesus. He also means, "Lord, take me up." Somebody praise the Lord. He said, "Lord, I trust you to direct my life. Lord,
rejoicing.
So the toddler is a away and love us. A joyous song of testimony. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. It's a different type of praise. It's a testimony praise. It's a testimony praise, Pastor, because whenever you want to look what God has done, amen, you can have a different praise. Somebody praise the Lord. Ah, when you shout out God, it's when you see the goodness of Jesus. It's when you look and observe the miracle in your life. Somebody praise the Lord. You could have been destroyed. Praise the Lord. You could have lost your mind. You could have lost your joy. Oh my God, when I reflect and remember what God has done, this praise is a testimony. Somebody praise the Lord Jesus. Ah, the Bible said it.
And rejoice and sing praises.
Praise the Lord Jesus. And so Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. That is when the Shama is released. We praise the Lord. And so the next one we look at is Barak. Let the church say Barak. Let the church say Barak. And Barak is unique because Barak means to kneel in reverence and submission. Somebody praise the Lord Jesus. And it is crazy that people didn't even know that by just kneeling at the altar, you worship your gods. But come on, man. You know, when you kneel at the altar, amen, it's a kind of worship. It's a kind of praise. Somebody praise the Lord Jesus. You kneel in the numbers and submission to God. the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. I want you to just close your hands and see every prison that is holding your mouth right now. Every prison that is holding your mouth. Every prison that is depressing you, that is discouraging you, that is breaking you, in the name of Jesus, release the seven praises of God on it right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, open up your mouth and say, in the name of Jesus.
Oh,